An anguished mother makes a plea for help tonight in solving her daughter's murder. 25-year-old Cassandra Peters was killed while working the night shift at Travelers Inn. Cassandra also lived at the motel as part of her pay. Cassandra's mother, Virginia, tells us Cassandra had big dreams. She wanted to be a nurse and considered this job temporary, but she'd been working six nights a week here for a year. Virginia says she wants justice on earth, but she knows God already knows who's guilty.
They may think they got away with it, but he knows all, and he will bring them to justice in one form or another. What goes around does come around.
Virginia says both she and Cassandra were concerned about her safety. Virginia says her daughter lived a low-risk lifestyle, but at a high-risk job. Cassandra's family members are not the only ones concerned. Now, we spoke to neighbors who say they're worried about the amount of crime at the Travelers Inn. Police tell us they've been called to the property 59 times this year to settle disturbances and investigate suspicious person reports. KMBC 9's Haley Harrison joins us live from the motel tonight with surprising stories of crime from nearby residents. Haley?
Well, Kelly, police say that they are aware of the crime issues here at the Travelers Inn. They drive through the parking lot often during their patrols, and they have a good relationship with the staff here. But neighbors say it has not been enough to keep crime off their streets.
You see those drug deals, you know, cars, they'll come down the street and they'll, two of them, you know, passing stuff off to each other, you know, that's what it is.
It is a community overrun by drugs, prostitution, and guns.
Just the kind of people that place brings, you know. None of us is perfect, but it's kind of, what do you want to say, riffraff.
Sunday's shooting death of the motel's clerk is the second homicide here in 3 months. In March, police arrested Natasha Fowler and Zachary Schoengert in the death of David Turner, whose body was found in the hallway. Police have been called here 59 times this year. It's also home to two registered sex offenders.
They ought to be listening to what the community is saying, and I'm sure the police are tired of getting calls there because that's one of the busiest divisions in the city.
Now, I talked to the manager of this motel tonight. He didn't want to talk on camera, but he did tell me he feels he is doing this community a service by housing those people who may otherwise be homeless. And when I asked him about what he thought about the fact there have been two murders here in 3 months, he said it was random. Reporting from East Kansas City, Haley Harrison, KMBC 9 News.